Good morning, everyone. Sweet Money here, and welcome back to another episode of Hack My Labor, the Starbase Tutorial Series where we learn some fancy tricks just by modding our starter labor module. Today we're going to be cleaning up the back of the ship since we tore it apart last episode and increasing our battery and propellant capacities to support these new thrusters and help with overall power needs. Friendly reminder to give this video a like if you're enjoying the series, and don't forget to subscribe so you don't miss the next one. I stream every Monday, Tuesday, Thursday, and Friday on Twitch. If you want to watch me figure out some of these upgrades live, you can follow me there. Let's get to work. First thing we should really do is slap some drywall on the back of our ship just to make things look a little nicer. Start out by spawning your ship and head straight to the back to see what kind of mess we left behind last episode. This back wall should be pretty easy. Craft yourself four 144 by 432 centimeter plates and two 96 by 144 centimeter plates. The giant 432 centimeter long plates should line up with the very edge of the beam at the doorway. Stack two of them to cover the full height of the wall. You'll have a gap in the middle that should fit our 96 centimeter wide pieces perfectly. Go ahead and fill them in here. Bolt everything down to all those new beams we just added last episode. That's looking better already, but how about these holes in the floor and ceiling? Let's fill those in, since that's the main reason I wanted to move the T-shaped ducts to the back wall in the last episode. All of these holes will fit a 96 by 144 centimeter plate perfectly, so craft yourself 10 more of those. Place them down so they're flush in each hole and bolt down the corners. The original labor module used white plating on the inside of the ship, but we don't have access to white paint just yet, so we'll have to live with the gray patch jobs for the time being. While all this plating is optional, the plating on the very back of the ship with all the thrusters is probably the most optional, so feel free to skip it if you don't mind seeing the beams back there. You'll need 21 24 by 144 centimeter plates and 8 48 by 144 centimeter plates for most of it. Two more 24 by 96 centimeter plates to finish up the top and bottom strips. Then you can finish any holes with two 24 by 24 centimeter pieces and four 24 by 48 centimeter plates. Just work your way into each crack and bolt things down as you go so the pieces don't fly away. And there we are! Besides the different colors, you would have never known we tore this whole back end up so shortly ago. Alright, since we switched to these triangle thrusters, our ship is going to burn through propellant a bit quicker than we used to. The next good upgrade we can do is add a couple extra propellant tanks so we can keep cruising along without worrying about fuel all the time. Go ahead and craft yourself four small propellant tank supports and two small propellant tank full. If you don't have ice on hand, you can craft empty tanks and fill them up at a refueling spot later. Head to the middle of the ship where the original propellant tanks are and snap two of these small supports right up against the back of the existing supports and auto-bolt both of these down. Now grab the propellant tanks you crafted and snap them to the supports you just placed. The line gauge should be on the bottom. Auto-bolting the supports again should secure the tanks. All that's left is to place the two additional propellant supports on the other end of our propellant tank. If you try and auto-bolt these supports, you'll probably add a couple of bolts to the generator unit since the supports are touching it. This may cause some durability errors. Pull out your universal tool and enable the durability overlay. Debolt the new supports that you just added, and then just manually bolt the support to the ship and the tank until everything is green. You'll want to keep an eye on this anytime you try to auto-bolt something that's touching some existing equipment. It's time to wire this up! There aren't any existing ducts here, so we're just going to run our cables around our new tanks to where the original propellant tanks connect. Feel free to get creative with the cable and pipe tool. I'm going to connect both tanks together first, and then run pipe down one side to the front, and cable down the opposite side, and then connect to the existing cables and pipes. Now if we go up front to our propellant gauge, we don't have any extra work to do. It already says we have 4 million capacity in our gas network. That should take care of the extra propellant we're going to need, but our ship's problem was never really propellant. It was power. Let's start to help that by increasing our battery capacity. We're going to start with a modest 8 battery upgrade. We'll probably need more than this when we start adding mining lasers, but this should help quite a bit for now. Craft or buy 8 small rechargeable batteries. Head to the front of the ship, where I was surprised how nicely a battery fits right next to the cargo crate here. Just stack 4 batteries on each side so they're flush with the cargo crates. Because I don't like having my batteries exposed this much, let's cover the front here with some plating. Again, this is very optional, so skip this step if you don't want to do it. For the front, I used two 144 by 288 centimeter plates, and then I filled in the gaps with 96 by 144 centimeter plates and two 96 by 96 centimeter plates. Just fill them all in and bolt them all down, and you should have a nice clean looking ship from the outside now. Now let's run some cables to these new batteries. Batteries are nice like cargo crates. All batteries that are lined up with each other will share a connection. You see this small rectangular plate or port on each side of the battery, so each side of the battery will pass along its connection as long as those ports are touching. This means we only have to connect power cables to a single battery in each stack. Let's connect the bottom battery by running a cable along the wall and connecting to the duct in the hallway. and then do the same for the other stack. And that's all there is to it. These batteries are connected to the power network, so if we turn on the generator, we should see them all start charging. Since all the batteries charge and discharge at the same time, we don't really need to change anything on our dashboard at this point. When battery 1 and battery 2 run dry, all the other batteries should be empty as well. I feel like we got a lot done today, but there's still plenty more to do. If you take your ship for a little test flight, you should notice that your fuel chamber unit rate is able to reach a point where it can meet your battery's demand, even if it starts at zero, so long as your battery is mostly charged. Next episode, we'll be focusing on more YOLO code. We'll learn about YOLO racks and memory chips, and revamp some of our existing scripts to work better, while adding some new functionality with some extra chips. Thank you very much for watching. If you've been enjoying this series, please do leave a like and subscribe so you don't miss the next one. I've been really blown away by the positive reaction of these videos, so comments are appreciated if you have any questions or suggestions. Another reminder, I stream every Monday, Tuesday, Thursday, and Friday on Twitch, where I do a lot of the experimentation work for these upgrades and learn how things work. There's a link down below if you want to follow me there. Thanks again for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. But for now, please, take it easy.